We're at the Memphis Botanic Garden. We're in front of this water oak. Huge water oak. Mm-hmm. And we're going to learn about tree physiology.
Yes.
This is the question we usually get. What is photosynthesis, though? How does that work?
Photosynthesis is where the tree's leaves absorb the sunlight and produces carbohydrates and sugars and provides the energy and the food for the tree.
So it's all about energy and food for the tree.
It's all about energy and food.
Okay. Now, it's been hot here lately.
Yes.
What about respiration, though?
Respiration is the process where the tree uses that energy that's produced by the leaves. But when it gets over 92, 93 degrees, the trees have cells that shut down the process of that photosynthesis and helps that tree maintain and retain the energy that has been already produced by the leaves.
Okay, which is really important because it has been above the 92, 93 degrees.
Yeah.
All right, now let's talk about the different layers of a tree. Let's talk about the xylem and the phloem. So let's start with the xylem.
Okay, the xylem works like with osmosis, and that is on the interior part of the cambium.
Okay.
And it pulls the water and the minerals from the soil, takes it up through the tree, all the way up to the tips of the leaves. Wow. It goes through the transpiration process where that moisture water is released through the pores of the leaf.
Okay. And what about the phloem?
The phloem tissue is the vascular section of the tree that takes that energy that's produced by the leaves and pulls it out through the tree and disperses it throughout the tree's parts.
Okay. So that flows in both directions?
Flows in two directions, yes. Or three.
Or three?
Yes. You have the rays of the wood, which run from the interior part of the tree outwards to where the sapwood is, and that carries the nutrients radially to the sapwood. Here we have, Chris, a slab of wood. This is a piece of red oak, and just to describe some of the physiological aspects of this piece of wood, or this red oak, we have the vascular tissue, or the is made up of four different parts, or more actually, but simple to simplify it, the bark, phloem, cambium, and xylem tissue. Phloem to the outside, the cambium in the center, the xylem to the inside.
Okay.
The bark is to protect all the other vascular tissue.
All right.
The phloem tissue is what brings the nutrients throughout the tree and disperses it from the leaves. Then the cambium produces both the phloem and the xylem tissue as it grows. And the xylem tissue brings the nutrients up from the root system up throughout the tree.
Okay.
Now, the rays that you see, the small lines right here running through there, those are your rays.
Yeah.
Yes, they're very pronounced, especially when the wood is dried up some.
Okay.
And these are your growth rings. So as the tree grows, it produces an annual growth ring, early wood and late wood. Now, the rays carry, it transports nutrients into the sapwood area, which is out here. Now the unique thing about the dysfunctioning tissue is all this wood that you see in here is non-conductive. It's just there for the support that I had mentioned earlier. Your productive and conductive tissue, or phloem and xylem tissue, is only on the outermost part of the tree right there. That's why a tree can be hollow and still function. Just like a solid tree. And then, of course, you'll have places where insects are living there, and the tree will compartmentalize over that.
Right.
But all through here, you have the cells that divide. When a tree gets wounded like that, the cells, the parenchyma cells, would divide and create new tissue and compartmentalize over the wound. That's how all this functions. That xylem tissue has the parenchyma cells that do that division.
That's pretty good.
That's how trees heal. When
that's
a tree gets wounded, the wound is permanent. When we, like, cut ourselves, we heal, but it's the same cell system that heals both our cut on our hand and the wound on the tree. It's the parenchyma cells. That's and it's closely related to how our bodies function. It's a living organism.
Now let's talk about the roots, though. What do we need to know about the roots of a tree?
Roots are very important. However, a tree can these trees that blow over, a tree can survive without having a complete set of roots because of the energy that the leaves can produce for it.
Okay.
So the roots function as anchorage to the ground, storage for what's produced by the leaves, and anchored.
Okay.
You know, keeps it anchored to the ground. That's when you see a tree blow over, you'll notice that there might be one root and the rest of the roots are dead.
Huh.
You know, it didn't have anything to anchor it to the ground.
About that, you know, most people think that tree roots grow deep down into the ground. That's not the case, though, right?
When they're young, they'll have a taproot. That taproot will either turn and go out and become part of the lateral root system, or it just dies off.
It just dies
off. It can't function properly. It can't survive unless there's water down there.
Okay.
Like a spring well or something down low that it can get nutrients and water from.
Okay. Now, what about the little tiny roots, though, the little fan roots that are right there at the surface?
The fibrous roots, yeah, the hair roots, roots.
Right.
Or the feeder roots.
Right.
They've got different names for them. They're very fine, kind of like our hair.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, about like that. And they absorb the moisture or the water, the available water.
Okay.
And that leads it all the way up throughout the tree.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's pretty much, you know, their function.
They're feeder roots, yeah.
They're just feeder roots. Mm-hmm. Just feed the tree. Now, this time of the year, we get a lot of questions about, oh, the leaves are falling off my tree so early.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because there's not any available water in the soil. Okay. And so the tree is saying, I need to stop using up the energy that I've produced so far and get rid of some of these leaves so I can start to rest and get myself ready for the winter.
Now, is that amplified?
It's just premature leaf drop.
And I'm about to get to that because we've had a lot of hot weather. So I wanted to just, does that amplify? What we're seeing?
Yes, it does, especially when the soil is as dry now as it is. And I mentioned the transpiration process stopping because of the temperature. Yeah, it all ties together.
Should we water trees?
Yes, you water in the
evening. How much would you water a big tree like this?
Oh my goodness, a tree this size could probably, if it's available, pull up 150 gallons a day. If it has the root system too.
Right.
And remember I mentioned that transpiration, you know, right. Where does that water go? It goes throughout the tree. It's a big tree. If it's able to transpire, it leaves the tree through the pores on the leaves.
Through the pores on the leaves.
On the underside.
Yeah. That has to do with what, stomates?
Stomates.
Things like that. See, yeah. I remember that from just simple biology.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. And the guard cells are what close the stomates to prevent them from losing all their water that they've taken up during these hot days.
Okay. Now, when you're watering your tree, I mean, should you use a soaker hose? Or
soaker
how
hose
would you
is
go
good.
About yeah, watering it?
I have a Ross Deep Root water
okay.
at my house. That way, I can turn the water on, and it's a long tube, attaches to the water hose,
okay.
and I work that probe down to the ground with that water, so I'm creating more airspace in the soil, and I'm getting that water down deeper. Yeah. When this ground is really compacted, sometimes that water doesn't percolate down through the soil.
That's a good
point. So. Okay. But other than that, a soaker hose is, to me, is best because that water that flies through the air and it hits the ground, it compacts the soil.
Compacts the soil.
That upper layer of soil, yeah.
Okay. When is the best time to plant a tree? How about that one?
I prefer the winter.
So you prefer the winter?
Late fall,
and
winter,
or
early spring. The temperature's not quite so hot. And the tree can rest through the winter as long as you put proper mulch on it. We have some trees that we need to get to the ground this October. Sometimes it's a matter of timing. Sometimes the weather's not real good in the deep winter, but
right. Yeah,
fall, winter, early spring.
Early spring would be the best time to do that.
Some people are planting trees right now. I don't recommend it.
Hmm.
I don't, it's just too hot.
Yeah, it is hot.
But a landscaper's got to stay busy.
Yeah, that's for sure. Well, look, we do appreciate, you know, all your valuable information that you have about trees.
Sure. Glad to be
tree
here.
Guy, right? Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please click the subscribe button below.